I've been doing this for a very long time, and I never lost anybody. This is upsetting to me. This is the first time that I remember that I lost a healthy patient. This patient would have been alive if there wasn't for the lockdown. The patient had a treatable, correctable disease. In February, and she had fibroid tumors. She was bleeding vaginally. And I said, look, you need to go see a surgeon today. Otherwise, you're going to bleed to death. She closed an appointment. And the day that she had the appointment, the doctor came in contact with somebody with COVID. So therefore, I'm going to put myself in quarantine for 2 weeks. And therefore, I can't do the surgery. Then it was like a Chinese fire drill, trying to find somebody to see my patient, because nobody wanted to see them because of the COVID. So finally, we got her in April, a month later. She had surgery and then removed the tumors. But by then, the uterus had grown so much, it put pressure on the small intestine. It caused a small fistula. Next day, she developed sepsis. They went back in. They found the fistula. By then, it was too late, and the patient developed sepsis and died about 2-3 weeks later. And I think most likely this patient would have been alive if there wasn't for the lockdown. If the patient was to be operated on March 1st, I believe she should be here today. The other upsetting thing about this, her husband and her mother could not see her while she's in the hospital, despite the fact she did not have COVID. And the only time they called her the day before she died, say, well, she's gonna die. We want disconnected from the ventilator. So the husband and the mother want to disconnect her from the ventilator. Very unfortunate, 49-year-old nurse, wonderful person. I'm so upset that this happened. I've been doing this for a very long time, and I never lost anybody. This is upsetting to me. This is the first time that I remember that I lost a healthy patient. Yeah, my name is Konstantin Kotsanis, MD. And this is my second opinion.